Oh, my really right. Sorry, no, me for shame, yo. Oh, my really right. Sorry, no, me for shame, yo. Oh, my really right. Sorry, no, me for shame, yo. Say what I need. Oh, by me. Oh, Lord. Say what I need. Oh, by me. Oh, Lord. Oh, my really right.
Thank you, Lord, on behalf of Oh, Glory to God. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father.
Bye. hear our peace, O God, in the name of Jesus, and thank you of our blessed sanctuary and all our guests from far and near. Peace, O God, in the name of Jesus. We are delighted to have you in our midst this evening. To continue this wonderful service, this Thanksgiving service to our Lord, sister, we will be taking a Bible reading from Psalm 74, and to take that will be Psalm of Calvary. Can you please sit your hands together for me?
Thank you. Thank you. Father, we thank you. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you adoration. With our hands, we worship you. With the lamps out of our youth and our hearts, the thousands of thoughts we all enough to praise you. We want you to know that we are grateful. On behalf of your daughter, she will tell you this, and we are grateful. For the days on the mountain, we thank you. For the days in the valley, we thank you. For the years of laughter, we thank you. For the years of weeping, we thank you. For the years of plenty, we thank you. For the years of mourning, we thank you. For all the days, we thank you. Because you are the Alpha, you have been a holy God, you have been everything in between. Glory, 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 glory be to your holy name. Please accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. This short word of exhortation, please speak to us. Just take all the glory. Yes. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Yes. Now, one more time before you sit down, give the Lord a big, 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 big hand of praise. And then in the peace, we sit down. Hallelujah. Thank you for that. God bless you. You know, there are days when we are not just the pastor, we are also the family. And on such days, it's usually very difficult to be the preacher. Because many dimensions to what you want to say. And it makes it really, really very, very difficult to preach on a day like this. But CK always my beloved sister, improve my word, please. Come on, let me give the Lord a big hand. My sister is only 50. It's really exciting. You know, I've had many messages by God's grace that I've preached on birthdays like this. And as I, you know, trusted God for today, it was too many things in my mind, because if I preach great is thy faithfulness, that would be great. Especially when I saw that hymn in the program. That would be a great message. If I preach, I will praise the Lord at all times. That would be a good message, because that's even in the program. As I was trying to do my lessons and look at which one fit me, I just discovered that the Lord sent me an unusual verse of scripture. In Psalm 31, verse 15, not the A part. Psalm 31, verse number 15. Simply says, my times are in your hand. Very clearly in my spirit, the Lord walked me to tell you that your time and to be honest, I had to meditate very strongly on that verse of scriptures as it relates to this meeting. Because then to me, I will have preached great in that picture. So the Lord's message that I am not consumed, because I happen to know some of the things that had happened in the last 15, 20 years. But when the Lord insisted that he has to be my times and in thy hands, it became clear to me that I can't preach here from my head. I have to really know what the Lord wants to say. My times and in thy hands has few implications. Number one, the reason you are still alive is that your time is all in the hand of the enemy. It's been in the hand of the Almighty. Yes, every now and then. I'm sure he came to the conclusion that Lord, except that my times have been in your hands, there's no way I will have been. And I believe in God is saying to you, the only reason that you
long.
My times and your hand, I believe David is saying, what appears to be a delay is God's program. Because David, I think, was the only king, if I've studied the scriptures very well, that was anointed 3 times for one position. So he's anointed in his father's house, you know the story. Anointed to be king over Judah. And then before, ultimately, because the original plan was that he would be king over Israel, but it was 3 times. And there are many things you have to do, not once, not twice. But because the time is in God's hands, and the fullness of time, he will show up. And what the enemy meant for him, the Lord turned it for good. I think the Lord deserves my times and your hands. The third implication is that everything that I've planned for you cannot be thwarted, cannot be frustrated. Amen. Because it's not in anybody's hand. Or is it
God's hands?
There are many attempts that there was great plan to thwart God's plan for David. But everything God said about David came to pass, including the fact that his throne will be forever. And that's why my Bartimaeus would say in Mark 10, 46, 52, especially 46 and 47, Mark 10, 46 and 47, he said, Jesus, thou son of
David.
Is the reason we could see Samuel in that extraordinary time of great devotion. Because I remember, like yesterday, and I was sharing it when we had dinner on your birthday. We had finished a Sunday service for the power conference. We had been waiting for Samuel for 9 years. I was going to Nigeria. I got sat on the plane, and then my phone rang that she was fasting. Be great. But when your times are in God's hands, there's nothing anybody can do. This sample is 2015 on January 27, 2024. If you are clapping, come on, give the Lord a big hand. He made me try everything possible to change God's plan for our Samuel to come. Because our times are not in the hand of the devil, it's in the hand of the Almighty God. And then say I was meditating and thanking God at that. It was you and I. You know, we left from the house to the hospital. We came to the doctor, we were there. And you and I were just waiting. Maybe we'll come. What's going to happen? But the times. Because God is not David is there. May you never experience divine termination.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah.
So if God fires somebody, then it's the devil that will hire us. But the moment God fired himself, the devil hired him. The Bible says in 1 Samuel 16:14, that the Spirit of God left him, an evil spirit God came upon him. My hands and your hands, God is saying, everything I want you to do must be done when I want you to do it. Because if it's not done, God cannot be helped. So I really have to authority. And while Elijah was boasting, really boasting, that I am the only one left, God said, no. 7,000. My hands and your hands, God is saying, there's no time to waste. When I ask you to do something, do it when I ask you to do it. As I drop the microphone to speak to all of us, we don't hold yourself. As a matter of fact, when I hear people say, it's my life, I do everything I like to do, I don't start. God picked us, breathed on it, and became a living soul. We are all living on borrowed life. The owner is the Almighty God. And I always will say that if I give you my car to use for some time and return, and you drive the car anyhow, the time for service, you refuse to service. And you will know. And now the engine is about to knock. What do you think I will do? Say it now. That's why it's important. That this one life that God has given to us, we must live that life according to his dictate. What he wants to do in the morning, don't do in the afternoon. What he wants to do in the afternoon, don't do it at night. Why? My time. If they are not saved, you can have a better time than today to live your life with Christ. But it doesn't matter how many years that you will spend here. We'll go. All of us. Jesus having his coming. We'll go. I was telling some pastors sharing that your great testimony with some of our pastors. That when you are dedicating the building, when I was a pastor the first time, it's been published. Again, we are 2,000. We are getting their name foundation on the it was foundation. And it was very great, like you read this after. Some of us small boys who are waiting for the great to stop. You know how the big foundation, the thing is up to like here. That is the game. That was small with these people. That he ran forward, jumped into the trench like that. When we saw one of us run, and we took our position to do the foundation. But that was I didn't even jump into any trinity. We thank God that it's strong, it's healthy, but I don't clap for God to that. Everybody is going over. Even the 8-day-old baby, they say,
careless as the Almighty God. Whatever I need to do to please you, please help me. I'm ready now. I'm ready now. Please, I am ready. I'm ready. If you want to give your life to Christ, you want to raise your hand up, pray for you. If all of us are saved, go leave it to God. And we'll just pray now and hand over the microphone. My Father and my God, we thank you. Thank you because our times are in your hands. Thank you for preserving us up until now. Thank you for your daughter in particular. Very soon, Daddy will be praying for her, and indeed all of us will be praying for her. Every prayer will pray for her today and subsequently answered by fire in the name of Jesus. Let her joy be full. The word that we have had this evening, let it propel us to greater works in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. If there be anyone surrendering their life to you, virtual church, all those that will hear this message after now, please save their souls to the very end. Your kingdom, count all of us worthy to reign with you. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. And while the message was going on that day, walking with mommy, and then we celebrated that day.
But it's also possible because you have not had a testimony. Maybe that's why you can understand. Every time she says one or two things in testimony, maybe you want to handle it. But thanksgiving is two words. Thanks and giving. So everybody's going to walk, nobody is giving. So while she is giving her testimony, then we'll be writing our giving. And when she's done with her testimony, I'm sure you will want to thank God at that time. Then the choir will then come back and maybe she wants to give some song by herself. So let's welcome the celebrant, the family.
Thank you. beyond explanation. Another incident is very important. If I want to know in my life, God, what is my favorite? This is what I thought. I missed my prayer for some months, so I went for just check up and said I had six or something. So they were going to evacuate or, do the things just to take it out. So I went to, we have to go, my husband was there. And when I came out, he was saying to me, that see, you want to start there, but you want like a baby now, a six. He was like, this was the baby that they're taking out. After that procedure, on our way home, I was feeling like a mad person. I was bleeding like, oh my God. I couldn't sit down, I couldn't stand, I was rolling on the floor. I couldn't sleep in the house, I was rolling on the floor. I was thinking about the other day. That God wanted, that God wanted my life. I was bleeding. I couldn't stay 1 second, everything was blood. But God delivered me.
So Yeah. on behalf of your daughter, on behalf of our family, we give you thanks.
Amen.
We give you praise.
Amen.
We give you adoration.
Amen.
We magnify you.
Amen.
Father, you are good.
Yes.
You are wonderful.
Yes.
You are merciful.
Yes.
When you issue a decree, it is established.
Yes.
We thank you because that is the reason we are gathered here.
Yes.
If you are not issued a decree that no matter what your daughter will be, she should have died. But with all the testimonies you have given, she is well alive. Dancing, jumping, praising God. Father, on our behalf, we give all praise.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we thank you.
Amen.
We bless you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for the family.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for making the family to be fruitful.
Thank you, Lord.
It is your dream.
Yes.
It's marvelous in our eyes.
Yes.
Father Almighty, thank you for my marriage.
Thank you
because the marriage is solid.
Thank you.
It is a fact.
Yes.
We know enemies that have tried, but you have put them to shame. To be, this marriage is peaceful.
Thank you, Lord.
Today, this marriage is joyful.
Thank you,
Lord. We thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you for making your daughter to attain the age of peace.
Thank you, Lord.
No matter, no wonder, little wonder is going. Your daughter is going. It's looking good.
Thank you.
Everything about that is good.
Thank you.
Glory be to your holy
name. Hallelujah.
We thank you for our husband. We thank you for the love, the call of love that is binding them.
Thank you.
Take all the glory.
Hallelujah.
We thank you. Thank you for
provision.
Father, above all, thank you for the salvation of their
souls.
Thank you because you have made them vessels of honor.
Father,
we are grateful. I pray, Father, that you will give your daughter a new beginning.
Amen.
A new beginning of joy.
Amen.
A new beginning of fruitfulness.
Amen.
A new beginning of peace.
Amen.
A new beginning of success.
Amen.
A new beginning of promotion.
Amen.
A new beginning of progress.
Amen.
Father, give us a new beginning.
Amen.
Lord, establish this family in God.
Amen.
Death
will
defy you.
Amen.
God will give you love for
us. Amen.
Sickness will defy you from
Amen.
Evil will defy you from
Amen.
You will continue to enjoy the fullness of God.
Amen.
God Himself will continue to draw you to Himself.
Amen.
Shall not fail.
Amen.
You shall not fall.
Amen.
You shall not forsake.
Amen.
You will serve the Lord more.
Amen.
You will fear the Lord more.
Amen.
You will love the Lord more.
Amen.
You will expect for the Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God is safe. God is is said. God is said. Amen. He continued to glorify himself in the life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
All those who may be planning evil against you, God himself will deal with
you. Amen.
As you are living for many more years, in the name of Jesus, you shall not win.
Amen.
You will serve the Lord to the end of the
world.
All those who are wishing you well, it will be well with
them. Amen.
All those who wish you evil will return to them.
Amen.
With you today. Peace of God will not be found wanting to their
family.
They too, on daily basis, in nothing festival.
Amen.
All your desires from the Lord, according to His will, will be granted.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
People will continually rejoice in you.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Blessed be your name.
Hallelujah.
We shall finish well.
Amen.
We shall finish strong.
Amen.
Jesus, bless the name of God.
Amen.
It's a seed in heaven on our behalf.
And I pray that every of the desire, also in celebration, the Lord will grant in Jesus'
name. Amen.
I really want to thank you. But I can't thank you enough. And that's why I've asked my Father to thank you. And he will really thank you.
Amen.
Thank you very much.
Are we holding that line? Please, are we right? Let's rise as we take the benediction now, and then please, all road leads to the pavilion right after now. Father, we thank you for the offerings and the thanksgiving that we have brought before you to appreciate what you have done in the life of your daughter. We pray that you will receive and bless in the name of Jesus. May it multiply unto us in 100-folds in the name of Jesus. Lord, as we go, O God, Jehovah, and we continue, O God, in this celebration, Lord, Father, may celebration ever continue in all our lives in the name of Jesus. Thank you, King of Glory, for how you have helped us. We worship and we exalt your holy name. We thank you, God, Jehovah, for this day. Yes, and you're going to give your daughter. As we go in your name, we go in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Who is this picture inside of Jesus now with me?
How many of you like high life? This is not high life music. This is the highest life music. The Zoe life. Our own is highest life music. Say highest life music. Eternal life is the highest life. Hallelujah. Man, are we ready? Are we ready?